Hey everyone, my name is Lewis, and we're starting a new show here on Offcast called StreamTech. So if you don't know, I've actually been streaming for quite a while. That's how most of the old content on Offcast got generated. I would stream events all over Southern California and throughout the world, really. So in that time, I gathered a lot of knowledge about streaming and streaming hardware and software and techniques. So what I wanted to do is to be able to use this channel to help kind of share that knowledge, because I know I don't really stream as much personally. Anyway, what this will cover is, stream gear, hardware, software, tricks and tips you can use. And one of the cool things is, since I work at XSplit, I get a lot of access to stream hardware and software that, most people might not have access to. So the first episode, what we're gonna focus on is something that I think most streamers use, and it's webcams. So when most streamers start out, they just start out with some gameplay, maybe add some graphics on it, but the first thing that their audience usually asks for is a face cam. They want to see their reactions to the game, and they want to be able to connect better with their audience. So given that, what most streamers do to add a face cam is they use a webcam. It's usually the most economical and easiest to set up option, and for a long time the standard go-to webcam was the Logitech C920. The C920 worked in a ton of different situations, and it was usually the hardware that would last the longest for you. You wouldn't replace it. And so, given that, since then, a lot of new webcams have gone on the market. Like, there's the new Razer Stargazer, there's the Intel RealSense cameras, and even Logitech themselves did an update to the C920 called the C922. So what this video is going to show you is it's going to show you a comparison between the C920 and the C922 and some of the new features in the C922, such as 60 FPS, 720p, the ability to do like a background removal with the chroma cam feature, and also to do things like the new low light performance and the new microphone on the webcam. And also, kind of compare the quality and see what improvements there is or is not with the C920. Anyway, first of all, let's kind of take a look at the physical differences between the C920 and the C922. So let's take a look at the physical differences between the two cameras. First up, you can see here we have the C920, and you can see this is a bit of an older C920. It has the Carl Zeiss logo right here. That's one of the older lenses, and also a bit of an older Logitech logo, but otherwise pretty standard C920 that you can buy on Amazon or buy in stores. Now let's take a look at the C922. So the C922, you can see it has the black here in the background. The logos are both new and have changed position, but otherwise looks pretty much the same as the C920. It even has the same shoe right here to attach to a tripod, and the same kind of speaker slash microphone configuration you can see here, the same type of glossy finish, but pretty much the same looking type of webcam as the C920. And as you can see here, side by side, the cameras are about physically the same size, they're about the same width. You really can't tell a difference between each other on the body, unless you can tell the difference between the logo placement and the black background here by the camera. So the first thing we want to check out is the image quality difference between the C920 and the C922 to see if one's better or worse. As you can see here, I have the two cameras hooked up, and we're going to go into XSplit. I've already added both cameras, and we're going to look at the difference between the two webcams. So here we have both cameras added here to XSplit. They're both set to 720p at 30 FPS. That's basically the standard setting for any webcam. And you can see just on first glance, there's not much difference in the image quality. There's slight color differences, but that could, basically depend on your lighting. But the one thing you will notice though is there's a lot more noise here in the C922's image, or actually the C920, excuse me. So the C920 has a bit more graininess, a bit more noise, whereas the C922 doesn't have as much noise, has a bit of a sharper image. So you know, all you visual buffs there will probably enjoy that. Otherwise, you know, visual quality, yeah, definitely slight improvement with the C922. So next, let's take a look at the 60 FPS functionality of the C922, and let's actually look at the image quality and compare that with the C920. So as you can see here, I've set the C922 to 60 FPS. You should probably be able to tell by the motion on the C920 and on the C922. On the C922, it should be a bit more of a smooth motion. But immediately you can tell that there is a difference in image quality. As you can see, the C922 has become a bit more blurry or washed out. There's not quite as much detail as in the C920. And I believe the main reason for this is because of USB bandwidth. So the C922 has to work with USB 2 ports and USB 3.0 ports. And basically, since it needs to work with a lot of different devices, it's still stuck with the limitations of USB 2.0 bandwidth, which is basically doesn't have enough bandwidth to do really high quality, high definition video. So this is why the image quality gets a little bit blurred, because it can't put as much bitrate into the image quality as you could at 30 FPS. And that's why it's a bit more murky looking. So if I change the C922 back to 30 FPS, you should see an image quality change right away. So there you go. Now I'm back at 30 FPS at 720p, and immediately right away you can see that the image quality has improved drastically once you go away from 60 FPS. So I mean, that's a bit of a trade-off. You could have, you know, smoother motion with 60 FPS. Let me go ahead and switch that back real quick and apply that. Yeah, so you can see here, you know, we have a bit of a faster frame rate, you know, with the 60 FPS, but again, you sacrifice image quality. Or you can get a high quality image, but you know, a bit of a lower frame rate. So let's bump that back to 30 and apply. And there you go, you can see the image quality improves quite a bit again. But yeah, that's basically, you know, how the 60 FPS works and kind of the limitations you're going with if you decide to switch to 60 FPS. Enabling 60 FPS is pretty simple, and any type of broadcasting software, XSplit specifically, you just have to right-click on it in your source list, click on the video output, and it'll pop up a window that allows you to change the frame rate. Now, 60 FPS can only be done in MJPEG, so make sure that that's your color space collection, color space compression that you select when you switch it. And yeah, let's move on to some more stuff with the C922. All right, so the next feature we're looking at is the chroma cam feature by Personify. What this is this is software-based background removal. So basically, it uses an algorithm to kind of look at you and to remove the background, similar to basically having a green screen. So this is a cheap way of doing green screen if you can't afford to paint your wall or have a backdrop on it. So inside any basic video production software like XSplit, what you have to do to activate chroma cam is you have to go to your webcam devices or video devices list and look for the Personify chroma cam for C922. You don't want to add the C922 ProStream webcam. Anyway, you click on that and the camera will initialize with the software running. And you can see here that it's already doing a pretty good job of removing my background. Like, of course, like, you don't want to do too fast motion because it has a hard time dealing with that. But, you know, if you stay still and you're just trying to focus on like your profile, it does a pretty great job. Of course, you also want to have good lighting. I don't know if we can kind of like show this with bad lighting, but I'll see if I can include that. But yeah, that's pretty much how Personify chroma cam works. And you know, let's add a backdrop to me. Let's toss in a video here. And you know, let's add me into my own video. So that's pretty much what the chroma cam looks like. It's just a simple way to kind of inch yourself into a game or some gameplay. And yeah, it's pretty cool. Of course, you can see it's tripping out a little bit because of my glasses right here. But yeah, just keep steady, have good lighting, and it's pretty easy to work with. All right, so the next thing we want to test here with the C922 is the low light performance. So this comes with a low light compensation setting. We've actually turned off some lights here in our place, and we're going to see how this kind of affects the look of the webcam inside the software. So let's go ahead and switch over to XSplit. So you can see here I've added the C922 web camera into XSplit, and right now it's set to 720p 30fps. As you can tell, there's a bit more detail going on. And also I've enabled the low light compensation. So you can see that even though it's a bit dark where I'm at, I still am coming through pretty nicely, and I'm still looking fairly clear without, you know, too much noise going on. Let's go ahead and disable the low light compensation now. Now, to disable the low light compensation, you basically, in XSplit, you can right click on the camera, and then you can click on configure on the camera tab, and then click video input. This will open up a window that says webcam properties, and you click on the camera control tab, and you'll see there's a checkbox for low light compensation. So I'm gonna go ahead and uncheck that right now and apply, and you can see immediately, like, it's gotten a lot darker, it's harder to see me, and you know, pretty much that's how low light compensation looks. Let's go ahead and enable it again. Now you can see it brightened up, there's a little bit less noise. Now there's one really important thing to take note of when using low light compensation. Basically, when you use the compensation, it's kind of just increasing the exposure, and when you increase the exposure in these webcams, that means you lose frame rate. So I don't know if you can tell exactly right now, but let's move my hand here with the compensation on. Let's turn it off, and you can see that the motion on my hand is a bit smoother with the compensation off. That's because generally when you turn on the low light compensation, it either lowers or limits your frame rate. So if you're trying to use 60fps and you can't, make sure to turn off low light compensation off and make sure to have as much lighting as possible, because the camera isn't able to get 60fps unless you have the proper lighting and also usually low light compensation disabled. So just an important thing to note. And then when you're working in low light places and you want the compensation, just know that you're gonna lose a bit of frame rate, you know, using low light compensation. So next up, we're going to test the microphone in the C922. One of the features that's been promoted quite a bit is that it has a noise reduction capability in it. So let's go ahead and switch over back to XSplit, and we're going to set it as our microphone device and check out how it works. So we're here back in XSplit, and we've set the C922 as a microphone device. That's pretty simple to do. All you got to do is go to the tools and general settings, and then click on the audio tab and set the C922 as a microphone device. So here it's set as a microphone device, and we're recording with it now. And this is how it sounds without noise. So let's get some noise going and compare the differences between my audio and you know, the audio coming from, you know, my microphone from my camera. Let's add a little bit of noise right now. So right here we have a fan blowing air. Usually this kind of adds quite a bit of noise to microphones. It's called wind noise. We'll check out. So first, let's go with the audio coming from the C922, which is me talking right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then we'll compare it with the audio coming from my microphone, you know, connected to my DSLR. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's how the microphone sounds. Hopefully it comes through clearly. We'll only be able to tell once we edit this all together. But yeah, that's the microphone on the C922. All right, so that about wraps up demoing the C922 and showing off some of its new features, and also comparing it against the C920. So first things is comparison with the C920. So as you can see, they basically look virtually identical. They look like the same camera, same kind of body. No real distinct physical differences aside from some logos and colors. Now, in terms of image quality, there is a slight improvement on the C922 with image quality, but that's only if you set both cameras to 720p 30 FPS. Now we didn't test 1080p 30 FPS mainly because you're gonna run into the same problem with going from 720p 30 to, you know, 720p 60, which is, it's basically more data with the same limited bandwidth. But yeah, at 720p 30, both cameras look pretty much alike in terms of detail. The C920 had a bit more noise. The color was a bit more off in terms of white balance. But on the C922, of course, yes, the image was sharper and the color, the white balance was a bit better. But once you set it to 720p 60 FPS, due to basically bandwidth limitations on USB 2.0, the image quality, you know, basically degrades. It becomes a bit smudged looking, blurrier, which isn't a big deal if you tend to have, you know, your webcam in a smaller window on your gameplay. But if you have like a full screen webcam, your audience is definitely going to tell a difference. But I mean, if you prefer the smoother motion, then that's fine. But I mean, I think if you want a really crisp looking 720p or basically HD face cam, you definitely want to upgrade to getting a capture card and getting like a proper camcorder, or, you know, even DSLR, whichever works for you. But you definitely want to make the investment to have that smooth motion and really clear image of your face, I guess. Next up was the chroma cam feature, right? So we looked at the chroma cam feature. Pretty much it's a neat little feature where, you know, if you're wanting to experiment with green screen, I would say it's basically like something to basically test the waters and see if you even want to invest in the green screen experience. So as long as you're still, it doesn't look too distorted or jagged. But you know, once you have motion or you have complex objects, like if you have really, you know, intense hair, you're going to see a lot of the outline and things popping in and out of the background. Also, you're going to still want to have really good lighting if you're going to use this feature. If you have poor lighting, it's not going to work too well. It's going to have a hard time, you know, isolating you from the background. Next up is the low light compensation. So the low light compensation, as you saw, was pretty good. If you're in a dark area, it brightens you up, but also doesn't introduce too much noise, like if you increase the gain. But it comes at a cost of lowering your frame rate. So, you know, in darker situations, you'll go from about 30 FPS to 15 FPS. In well-lit situations, you'll basically limit yourself to 30 FPS. You won't be able to hit 60 FPS. So if you want to hit the higher frame rates, you'll have to disable low light compensation. And finally, we tested the microphone. So one of the features from the microphone that, you know, was kind of, you know, emphasized was that it had a noise reduction or noise cancellation type feature. So we tested it with just adding some wind noise, and usually that's really what is most disruptive to mics. Like someone might be, you know, playing and having a fan on because it's a hot night or a hot day, or they have the AC on. And as you could tell, like the microphone was so sensitive that any little bit of noise or anything really disrupted things, and it didn't deal with the wind noise too well. So, I mean, you know, to be honest, I don't think most people depend on the microphone from their webcam. If they do use it, it's usually to do something simple like a Skype call or something quick. People usually have their own standalone, you know, microphones or a headset. So, I, you know, you can't really knock it too much. It's a cool thing, but at the same time, it didn't really seem like it was doing any type of noise cancellation. It seemed about the same as, you know, any other mic dealing with that type of noise. But yeah, that's about it. If you have any questions about the camera, I'd be glad to answer them on the comments section. If you'd like to hear about different kind of stream tech, like software or different types of hardware, let me know. And yeah, we're hopefully going to keep the series going, show you some new hardware, show you some capture cards, software, mixers, and any type of thing that'll, I feel, will be helpful for you in your streaming career. And hopefully we'll save you a little bit of money, because streaming isn't cheap. But yeah, my name's Lewis, and catch you next time.